Hello guys, it's Peter from PS Sound, and now someone can see how these videos happen. Thomas, who's brought this beautiful Audi A7 2015 model to us for a tuning session. He built the system himself, right? You built everything. Yeah, everything yourself. It still needs a bit of finishing in the trunk, but it's definitely sounding beautiful now. Come on, let's run through what you have in here, because the sub box is obviously unfinished yet, and you see the subs upside down because originally the subs were facing forward. He said that he found them sounding the best that way, but today we tested them facing up, facing back, and then measurements showed very easily that this is the best option in this car to get the best upper bass and the best integration to the front mid bass. So we turned it back around. Now you can but now you can turn the subs around. But we also talked about solution to possibly rebuild the box, because the box is square at the back and a lot of space could be saved. Yeah, so it goes straight down, and now there's like 8 inches at the bottom from the seat. All that airspace could be used, and the push then, sorry, the sub could be pushed further. It would leave more space in the trunk. So these Helix Q12s are in relatively large sealed boxes. You said it was like 40 something.
I think it's 100 liters
total, and they share the space. It definitely plays low, crazy low. It can do hat tricks. We proved that today on low lows below 20 hertz. It was even playing that crazy tune at 11 hertz. It was playing pretty well, yeah. but the voltage in the car was pretty low, so we had to struggle with that. We learned that your battery is dead. You need a new battery. So that's where he managed to hide most of the equipment. Oh, we can't even leave that now. So we have a Helix M6 running the front end, the freeway active front end. Power distro is down there. The DSP is in front of this in the corner. You can just see something. Yep, it's there. DSP is hiding there. A Helix
Pro
Mark II. Yep. Giving 10 channels, you only use 8, but you have 2 channels left, and that's where you have the rest. Is it coming off like that? That's where you have the Zen box for the Most 150 integration, because the car runs on Most 150, not on 25, and you use optical out of that to the DSP, right? And then two of the M1X monoblocks running the subs, one monoblock each. The other one is behind this at the back. So there's plenty of power. Now you just need battery power.
There's always improvement.
Exactly. Especially when people come to me, then they realize what can be done. So up front, factory location for mid bass, custom pillars he built, and the tweeters are in the factory dash location firing up. So the phone is connected to the head unit running on Bluetooth. People would cry that, oh yeah, but it's shit Bluetooth. Whatever. Come here, I tune your car, and then tell me it sounds shit after it's tuned. People always get lost in upgrading speakers, amplifiers, everything else, and they have no idea about what potential is left in the car until it's tuned. And then even with this Bluetooth connection, it sounds great now. And whatever comes out of the Most box on optical, it's very good. It doesn't have compression, it doesn't have a high pass filter, nothing. It plays all the way down, down to 11 hertz. We tested it today. System is plenty dynamic even on Bluetooth, but you have a head card for the Helix as well, right?
Yeah.
We haven't even tried that today, but you will be able to try whether that shows. Oh, I pressed something. Is it the radio play now, or is it still you playing? So we go back to media, and then it's your phone. Okay. But it's that easy to use the system this way, because everything goes through that. All the factory controls work. Exactly. That easy. That easy to use a system like this. And we could call it an OEM Plus system, because only the mid-range is the only thing that shows any sign of a custom system. And what we haven't mentioned, it's this Stag Freeway, whatever. What model is it?
It's
It's not a. Is it a customizable set that you put together,
it's
or it comes like this?
They come two way, but then you can buy the mids separately.
I see. Well, we were talking about it, and this Stag Freeway is roughly around 700 ish in Europe, because we don't have this in UK. And it sounds very good. The mid bass in the Audi doors are very punchy, very tight. Doors behave pretty well after Thomas did extensive work on them. It always is. Mids are great. Only the tweeter in that location is not the best. But after the tuning, it blends in well. And the funny thing is, most people wouldn't even tell that the high frequencies come from anything else but the mids. People would think that these are wide bands, because you hear everything from the mids or the high frequency range as well. Yeah, don't expect me to have a demo now, because we have to go soon. Oh, that's what you have. SQ32 with ME30 and ME650. Yep. It's great, honestly. For the money, it's a great set. And we got great results out of it. And this system is definitely an animal. We had two presets on the director. So there's an SQ preset. And then number three is bass, when there's different settings for the mid bass and the sub, where the sub can come alive, go mental. And now I use this word again, people always tell me, always say this word, mental, crazy. Oh yeah, with triple Z, crazy. So yeah, these two subs can move the car and move decent amount of air, yet stay very musical. On the SQ preset, subs are EQ'd and tuned so differently that it blends into the front beautifully. The mid bass also plays low on the SQ preset. But yeah, on the bass preset, they are crossed higher, so we can send them and really feel the music. No, it works really well. So here it is, another system for you guys, just a bit of inspiration. Let's just show it from the front. It's on the charger, we had to charge it all day. Figured out the battery is very bad. It's definitely nice, a nice looking car. Hang on, I shut this door, then people can see the sideline of it. Yep, it's a nice looking motor. So here we are, another car tuned, going home happily. I don't say anything about it, but I think those who follow this channel know exactly what's going to happen to this Suzuki Swift, Mrs. car. Yep. That's gonna have a lot of content coming, guys, so don't worry. So this is it for this tuning session. Bring your car to me, let me tune it, and if you don't like it, you can go away without paying a penny, but with your own preset, right? Because we know what happens when it gets tuned. What was it? Was it worth it to come here and get it tuned?
Of course, especially when I get a Honda.
Well, okay, that's another experience when people can hear that. What did you think of the Honda? If you could sum it up.
Crazy. I think I never had system like that. Is what I could say. So the music where you play is not like my type.
Yeah.
But I liked it.
Yeah.
It produced some more different genres.
Yeah, it opens up people's
I like
preference.
Shakers
as well.
Nice,
IB subs. But then we started with quality music when we were listening to bare recorded stuff, and you were even saying that
yeah.
The stage depth was something new to you. That
when the guy was playing the saxophone as well,
yeah,
you could tell it when he touches,
yeah,
and starts playing.
You could tell so many details from a recording, and yeah, and it's realistic, it's lifelike. Then we send the system mental, and then things come alive.
Yeah, but you have both rules.
Everything. Yeah. Well, your old system can be a bit of that. I love these subs, honestly. Once you rebuild the box, you can push it further, trim it, have a protective panel in front of it, or you bring it back for a day, we build a nice trim panel with lights, use those factory light circuits, light it up white. Done.
Yeah.
With this car, it would look stunning. your paintwork is pretty good. Yeah, we just left a lot of marks on it today. No, that wasn't me. That wasn't
me.
Yeah. Stunning car. So this is it for this one, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Another short walk around showing a tuning session and the impressions. Yeah, your
Make
impressions
sure you subscribe of it. To PS Sounds.
Exactly. Follow what we do, because this is not the general car audio place. Definitely
not. It's not Halford speaking.
Yeah, just a little bit different. Cool, this is it. See you in the next one, guys.